Very good morning. How are you all? Fine. Okay. So this session is about, you know, orienting you towards the core batch, giving the details about the core batch. And so the session mainly focuses on what you should expect from the core batch and what we will be doing in the core batch, right? And what is the essence of the core batch? So what is the concept behind core batch? What is the uniqueness of the core batch? So all these things I'll be discussing. So can somebody tell me the meaning of orientation? So today is the orientation session. Alignment. Yeah, very good. So that is what? Aligning you, no, towards the core batch. And what do you mean by core? What? Yes? Center. Okay. So we want this core batch to be a flagship mainstay program of Insights, and it has been actually, and it has delivered excellent results since 2014. Midway, what happened? Like, you know, we started with around 40 students in 2014. It was nothing but core batch. The same way we conducted an entrance exam for you, we conducted then. So 2013 July, we started our website. By December, we were very popular because of daily answer writing initiative, which we started for the first time, and then started secure and became so popular that, you know, more people started following our website. So in the month of December, we conducted a poll. If we conduct offline program in Bangalore, will you be interested to come to Bangalore? So 311 people, you know, said yes. So we are ready to come to Bangalore. And then we wanted, because it was the first batch, we wanted to take only 40 students. We kept an entrance exam. So they had to write an essay exam. And when we announced there will be an essay exam, so only 150 people agreed, yes. Right. And we gave the question paper. And there was a time limit within which they had to send their essays. We received exactly around 111 essays. Out of that 40 people, we selected. So in the very first batch, so we got rank 26, rank 8, rank 36, rank 97. And out of 40 students, in the end, you know, only around 12 people were there when the last exam was being given to them. Because it was so hectic, half of the people left after 3 months. It used to be very hectic, hectic than the timetable given to you actually. But it started in the month of January 2014. So we had to rush. Every day there used to be exam. Every day there used to be evaluation, personal feedback. And we started in this small school classroom. So then, you know, because of the result, next year we started the core batch again, once again. Then there was main test series. It used to be kind of semi-philanthropic kind of program. So then again we got rank 1 and then rank 3. So we became popular. So I grew ambitious and thought that in 2017 we will start a unique program called offline guidance program. It was actually mix of core batch plus mix of classroom program. So one problem I didn't anticipate was that, so when we started this program, both freshers and both veterans, those who had given mains and all, they both applied in equal numbers. So it was challenging to teach both of them in the class in the same manner. If we taught advanced, freshers were complaining. If it was too basic, advanced people were walking out of the class. So it happened in 19 also. So that is why this year we have bifurcated. So OGP 2009 is purely for freshers, right? They will have test series and everything. But this core batch, as we have already stated in the article on the website, is an advanced program. Advanced program in the sense that this program doesn't intend to help you clear, help you mains, but it intends to maximize your marks in mains. Clearing prelims is kind of foregone conclusion, because prelim test series is integrated and almost you will be writing 2 to 3 exams every week, right? That will also take care of prelims. So I will explain how it takes care of prelims as well. But when it comes to mains, when we analyze marks of toppers, right, it is some people get, you know, 2 good marks in optional, or 2 good marks in essay, or 2 good marks in the interview, and then go on to clear this exam, right? But if somebody can balance out marks in all the papers, slightly above average in all the papers, and, you know, doing very good performance in the interview, like 190 plus kind of scores, somewhere seals your rank within top 100. Now, what is the good marks in GS 1, 2, 3, 4 as per 2018? Anyone? For that matter, essay. So, essay scoring 150 plus is, I mean, it's very good, right? So, 140 to 150, like more than 150, very few people have scored. 140 to 150, a decent number, but those who have got ranks, right? But when it comes to GS 1, 2, 3, GS 1, the scores vary from 70 to 120, GS 1. And GS 2, the more or less every year the same case. Topper, somebody scores 115, 120 and all. Most of the people score again 80s in 90s. GS 3, people have advantage, the more of factual paper. So, there people have scored till 130 plus also. Paper 4, same, like again 120 plus, nearly 130 people have scored. The very intention of the core batch is to put you in the bracket of 110 in all the 4 GS papers. So, in all 4 GS papers, you will be in the bracket of 110, provided from test 1 to 130th test, without fail, without missing, you go on giving, no matter what is happening around you or what is happening to you, right? And after prelims, again we have mains test series, around 25 to 30 tests will be there. So, overall you will be giving nearly 160 mains oriented tests before next year mains. And parallelly, you have already around, you know, nearly 40 prelims tests, which is, you know, integrated with the core batch timetable. So, it is not like biased only towards mains. The prelims test series is also there, which is, you know, it is not contradicting the timetable. So, what you study for the mains test series, for every test, the same thing will be tested through prelims MCQs as well. So, there is no confusion ki, like, you know, you have to spend extra time for prelims, you know, nothing like that. Except where, you know, world history, society and security issues, and which are main specific topics, right? So, there we don't have prelim test. Other than that, every topic is actually integrated with the prelims test series. You will be, again, this is part of the core timetable, around 40 prelim tests. Apart from that, there are again another 100 prelim tests, which we will make you available for extra practice post March, right? I mean, with the part of subject wise test series and the OGP has its own 58 prelims tests, right? So, looking at the nature of the exam, you know, which is evolving every year, the expectation of this exam is that they want a thinking candidate, they want a smart candidate. The one who wrote learns, or learns through rote learning, right? So, he is being kept out of the services. Anyone, you know, who doesn't invest his own, you know, intellectual investment, I call that. So, who doesn't invest his own intellect, so he is being kept out of the services. Prelims, why there is delay in, you know, I mean, why it consumed so much of your time? You had to think, right? Think to eliminate, think to guess, whatever it is, the thinking has become very much part of the exam, right? So the core batch, which has so many prelims tests and mains tests, seeks to, you know, make you think on day-to-day basis, literally day-to-day basis, because you have to think while preparing. I will tell you like why you have to think while preparing. And when you come to the examination hall, you have to think to write an answer. And when you give prelim test, this year our nature of questions are going to be challenging, the way UPSC has been evolving the setting, right? So we have put a research team where the questions will be focused more on, like, you know, it is like, you know, series of UPSC exams that you are going to give for the entire course of a year. There will be unexpected questions, there will be bouncer questions, but again nothing out of the world. Everything within the scope of the exam, everything within what UPSC can ask in the future. And that demands your thinking in the examination hall, because when we start with 10 questions, so we will time it say 1-1.5 hour. To answer those 10 questions in the first test, the thing you read and come will not be sufficient, right? Because you will have to apply yourself in the examination hall. Out of 10 questions, the 5-6 questions what you have read might come, another 3-4 questions for which you will have to think on the spot. This will, you know, if repeated again and again over the course of 1.5 years, when you actually go to examination hall, it becomes very natural to you. You know, you don't have to think a lot compared to other candidates who doesn't go through this kind of process. And why this timetable? Why this kind of timetable? Some people keep like a kind of unrealistic, very hectic and all. So in first batch, second batch, third batch, we noticed that the people who go on to become toppers actually do this kind of practice. With or without the timetable, they do it. I vividly remember rank 26 Neha Kumari. I mean, I keep giving her example because she was our first student. The kind of hard work she did in this matter of 10 months, so January to October, November, when she gave mains, so that yielded her rank 26. Because literally every day she used to write minimum 10 answers. So we used to post 8 to 10 secure answers. She used to write that, and over that we used to give exams every alternative day, right? And sometimes every day also. So she used to answer them also. It is something given to you in form of question paper, in form of assignment. You will have to take it very seriously, because everyone sitting here in this classroom is aiming for a rank. And the rank now doesn't come easy. You have to earn it, right? And you cannot earn it by staying relaxed and, you know, by staying, the old attitude is gone now. You know the competition, right? I mean, imagine for every 1 mark, there are now 15 candidates, right? I mean, if somebody has, for example, just 1020 mark, so 1020, if there are 10 candidates, right, they are all fighting for one service, and for the same mark, now the cadre also differs, or service also differs, right? So I am not scaring you, right? So what I am trying to say is that you have to shed your older self. The moment you have decided to be part of this core batch, you have to shed the older version of yours, and you have to align with, you know, what this timetable is going to demand from you. So what it demands is that, one, first of all, if you have decided to be part of this batch, right, you have to take a vow that you are not going to miss a single test, come what may. That is number one rule, because that itself will ensure, like, you don't realize the I don't understand, or I don't know, like, you may be are you able to imagine what I'm trying to say. This will ensure, you know, more marks in mains by default the entire year. Average candidate, like for example rank 5 Srushti Deshmukh, so and rank 2 he has also told, every day they used to write answers, right? These people are first timers, right? First rank, first attempt. They have told on various platforms, every day they used to post answers, write answers without missing a single day, right? I mean, by default they are there in the top 10, do well in your optional, score somewhere around 300, you are there. And again, look at their interview marks, it is somewhere 170, 180, something like that. They are not there in top 10 by scoring 200 plus. It is because of what they did throughout an year, right? And that consistency in your, you know, attitude, in your decision when you follow something is extremely important. A very insecure candidate, underconfident candidate always changes his or her strategies. You know, go from here to there, change this timetable, change that material. Somebody who has faith in their own ability, somebody who has faith in something, you know, which someone is offering, right? They are unwavering, they don't change. And it is, if not this attempt, next or other attempt, they 100% get through, that kind of candidates. But those who, you know, like keep changing, like, you know, they try it again, they don't try it 100% something, and they think that it is not suited to them, or it is too hectic or too unrealistic or something, or they justify saying that I am not that kind of personality, right, to follow such kind of a routine or timetable. That is why I am saying you have to find newer version of your personality. Anything you do from this moment onwards, July 3rd onwards, the first test onwards, is going to change you positively. So there is nothing negative about this, right? And the learning curve will always be kind of exponential here. You will go on learning new things, you will go on using that information effectively. And so, you know, there will be space for you to discuss after the test. We will be discussing, you will be discussing. So we want to make this batch kind of, you know, where everyone discusses, where everyone learns without having any kind of pressure, without having any kind of stress, right? So we want this batch to be that kind of batch, right? So you feel free to come and ask any doubts, any feedback, and we want to be engaged throughout the year with this particular batch, because I am more than 100% sure we will do our part. So we will give tests like clock-like precision, right? We will give better synopsis, we will give better evaluation, we will keep doing our part. Now, the one and only expectation from our side is that you have to come and give all the exams, every exam, right? Never judge, I mean, don't act smart, never. These are again excuses, acting smart in the sense that, you know, you write 2 to 3 tests, then you say that, you know, the question paper is not UPSC-like, so I will not come and write the exam, or somebody fills you that idea. These questions are not like UPSC. So when we do something, there is a thought process behind that. In this moment, you won't realize it, why we are giving like that. But it starts making sense when you actually go to the exam, right? So the moment you start judging something, the moment you start, so if there is a lack of quality in feedback, you come and complain, right? Like if it is not evaluated properly, be free and come and, you know, scold us. So I will accept that. But when it is about the question paper, question qualities and all, so we have a team, you don't take the decision. Why I am telling this is that it's not about we don't want to improve or anything. If at all you really feel that, you mail us. But don't give up. It becomes an excuse for you to stop doing what you are doing, right? And you will start finding for an alternative which doesn't exist later, right? To find an alternative, you know, alternative option and going after that, you will lose that momentum in between, right? So the moment you start, you know, rationalizing, trying to find excuses, remember these words, the orientation session words, where we are asking you to follow it, right? So have blind faith. Believe it or not, like these kind of the words I used to speak in the beginning of every batch. The most unfortunate thing is that, so after prelims, people come, suddenly, you know, they appear from nowhere. So are you in OGP 2019? Yes, sir. So I have never seen you. So I should have met you before. I should have come and frequently met you before, but I didn't come. So today I am coming, give me a timetable, give me, you know. So I will start coming to you again and again, please guide me. I mean, you didn't have to waste 1 year, right, for that. All it takes is that, again, I keep telling, whatever your old version, just kill it. You have to be open, you have to be forthcoming, you have to come and speak to people. You will never know what mistakes you are doing unless you speak to someone who has experience. And standing here, like, you know, I have this experience of personally seeing the first rank, you know, what it takes to be a first rank or third rank or 26th rank. This year, Sri Lakshmi, 29th rank. Now, I used to tell her, like, you know, Kerala might get first rank. It may be like, you know, 10, 20, 30 marks difference here and there, but they are nonetheless still like first rank only, right? And when you see a candidate, when you see the way they work, the way they answer, the way they behave, you know, we can tell that, acha, so you are going to be a topper. And we will be sharing those things, you know, what kind of attitude is needed. There is a kind of attitude that is actually needed for this exam. So we will be sharing those things throughout the course, right? It is not like, you know, giving you an exam and sending you back. So it has to be a cyclical process. So you will go back, study, you will come back, talk to us, get the feedback, right? So if you are in that loop again and again, your motivation will be high, right? The tendency to deviate will be very less. And please, you know, you should come and talk. It actually works. No, I am not telling you should come and speak to me alone. It's like we have so many mentors, so many faculty also, right? We can come and speak to anyone. Okay. So now coming to the timetable of the core batch, right? Now the one fundamental question that people keep asking, how will I manage my optional with this kind of timetable? So where do you fit your optional? How will you manage your optional with this kind of timetable? So number one, the criteria was, should I have completed optional, right? So we like boldly put it like, you know, you should have completed optional. I hope that is what happened with most of the people. I think you have read once or twice, thrice, and you have made notes, right? But along with this timetable, if somebody has changed their optional, right, or if somebody again wants to give more time to optional, along with this batch, the one thing you can do is like put 4 to 5 hours, like 4 hours. We have mentioned 3 hours here, like 4 hours fixed every day only for optional, right? And remaining, like when there is no exam, assuming you are going to study for 10 to 12 hours, 12 hours you can study, right? Everyone?
Yes.
Is there anyone I can study only 6 hours, 8 hours? Hey, see, give it as your one last attempt. Give this attempt as your one best shot. After that, you know, whether you pass or fail, don't give this exam. Or, you know, don't prepare the way you are going to prepare. You don't have to prepare also, because you will have got that base, the writing fear, everything will have vanished, right? You can join a job, leisurely you can give the exam, still you might clear, provided you keep updating yourself with the current affairs. Now and then keep revising your optional and other, you know, notes. You don't have to stress yourself and work like this, right? So every day 4 hours, you fix it for optional. Now I have assumed that everybody has completed reading your optional. So that 4 hours must be one revision and writing, answer writing, right? So go systematically in the sense that have a target of November, right? Maximum by December, you will have to answer at least 500 questions. The core batch people, it is like compulsory. Once in a week, we will, like when you come for the test, we will check, like, are you writing answers regularly or not? Some might tell, I have already written few answers. No, doesn't matter. You start again. You might have written answers as part of test series. You might have written answers. If somebody had taken this suggestion seriously last year, might have written few answers. But again, you will have to write. Again, writing answers, like from where will you source the question? Previous year, question papers. I think every optional has around 15 to 20 years questions, right? So 4 hours, give it only for doing optional every day. It is not like, you know, some people have the habit like 2 to 3 months I will do only optional, then I will start doing GS answer writing, then I will start with the prelims. Never do that mistake, right? So remaining 6 to 8 hours must be kept solely for 3 things. That is, even when you are part of the core batch, compulsorily, without fail, every day you need to answer secure questions. So that is one way, one, like, you know, assured ticket to success, which we will test in every core batch exam. So even though the static is there, for in every test we will include secure questions also, right? In every core test there will be secure questions. If you write those secure questions, only then you will be able to answer them. If there are 10 questions, like 3 to 4 will be secure questions. So whatever preceding days are there on those questions, you need to prepare. Like how many answers you should write? Ideally you should write all the answers, but that is impossible. It's not possible. But again, some people have done that previously. People have written more than 10 answers, 15 answers every day. Why people don't write or continue it regularly is that they try it in the beginning. You know, they do lot of research and they want to write excellent answer. So to write one answer, they spend 1 or 2 hours. To write two answers, they spend 3 or 4 hours. Then they get scared. So I'm not able to give time for optional. I'm not able to give time for prelims test series preparation. So they try it for 3-4 days and then they give up, right? It actually takes more time in the beginning. It should take, because if for the first time you are doing it. But believe me, if you do it for 20-25 days without pausing, the time you spend on secure gets drastically reduced. You will reach up, you know, efficiency where in 2 hours you will actually write all the 8 questions. The 6 or 8 questions which we post, within 2 hours you will actually answer all the questions. The problem here is that you try it for 1 week, 10 days, then you give up, then again you try it. That inconsistency, again, inconsistency is the problem. Allot two most productive times of day for these two things: one, secure answer writing, and another, optional answer writing. So if you have the habit of getting, you know, waking up early in the morning, so then better you give it for optional answer writing. Prepare and write optional. Then if you're a person like who regularly sleeps in the afternoon after having lunch, then maybe that time can be allotted to secure answer writing, though it may not be most productive, but at least it may not be most productive time of your personality, but you can spend the time productively on something, right? You have to figure it out. Or if you individually come, I can ask you how you manage your day and I can give the timetable also, right? But these two must be done from, say, like tomorrow onwards to till end of April, you need to write secure answers, right? Now it is not like, you know, I will start my preparation from January for prelims, or after March I will start, because you are starting prelims preparation from day one actually. from now itself you are starting. So that question doesn't arise where you have to, where you will say that, you know, writing secure answers or writing answers till April will affect your prelims. It's not like that. And then 1 month you can, you know, revise in the month of May. May 31st is the prelims. Then again you can take 1 week break. Then again you have to resume, right, after prelims for mains. There will be mains test series for you and you will have to continue that. So if you can do this, I mean, I don't know, like 110 or 120, you people will raise the bar, people will raise the competition. So does it feel realistic to you? Can you do this? Like how many are there here? I can hear only 4 or 5 yeses. Now can I hear louder yes?
Yes, sir.
Will you really do it?
Yes, sir.
So what is the guarantee that you will not deviate? What it takes for you to not to deviate? Not to deviate in the sense, to stop doing this, writing answers regularly, like optional, and how will you, the moment when you feel like, okay, no, I am not feeling like writing today. If you do this 2 days consecutively, third day you will not write. Or sometimes even one day if you don't write, because tomorrow you feel that yesterday's answers I haven't written. So you take up yesterday's question, then you see that today's question also. You tell yourself, I cannot write these many answers today. And it stops there. Right? I keep wondering, like, you know, during when we were preparing, nobody was there to tell us like this. I never did answer writing. Wish I had written. Wish somebody had told me that, you know, do write answer. No, not a single optional answer, not a GS answer. Still went till interview and all. But I mean, we didn't know that, nobody told us. No, people are, you know, like forcing you. Even then some people don't do it, right? You will have to do it because number one is, it's sure way to success. No harm is going to happen to you, right? Nothing negative will happen. You will actually grow as a more very good, you know, intellectual person, very disciplined person, very humble person also, because you will learn issues in and out, right? It will make you humble also, you will realize that. That is, everything is positive about it. Then you will have to keep telling yourself, why am I doing this? So what is the purpose? Everybody has a story, everyone sitting in this room has your own story, like why you are here. And you have seen so many failures, right? After every failure, again you have experienced so many setbacks in terms of, you know, parental pressure, relatives pressure, some people, you know, detractors, doubters, haters, everything, like you people have experienced every kind of reaction from every corner, right? So the one and only answer to shut down all negativity, where people, you know, keep doubting you, but you keep believing yourself. You keep giving time to yourself, you keep trying new things. Somewhere you feel that you really have in it, you need one proper direction or one proper attempt where you need to give everything, like 100%, right? So getting the rank, you know, seals everything here in this exam, right? Like this exam is everything in this country. I mean, you transform, even today, I mean, when did the result come? Last June? May? April? April 5th. Yeah. So, it is now nearly end of June, people are still celebrating. You know, in the WhatsApp status, I see felicitations everywhere. Right? Everywhere felicitation, people are enjoying, relaxed. And the proud parents, they are celebrities in their own communities. And these people, you know, already Bharat Darshan, the toppers. So before actual Bharat Darshan, now they are seeing the whole country. And yeah, everything changes for you. For that, I don't think the kind of effort you have to put from today onwards to say till next September. So it is nothing actually. So it is going to liberate you. It is going to free you from all kind of, you know, negative things that you are remotely or directly or indirectly were experiencing today. You are able to relate to what I am trying to say, right?
Yes.
You are experiencing such kind of things,
yes.
Right? Yes. You are experiencing those kind of things. So this program, again, it's not about insights or it's not about anything. This program is all about you. Getting the best out of you, actually. So we are not going to teach you any basic things in the class. We are not going to spoon feed you anything. We want to help through this timetable, through this rigorous program, to find the best version of yourself, which never existed, which you think maybe existed, which can come out. I mean, it is not ordinary thing to, I know how difficult it is. If I am sitting and on that side, if somebody is telling me, yeah, motivation comes to me, yes, I should write and all, the moment I start, it's very difficult. It's not that easy to write, you know, say four answers, four secure or four optional answer. But I'll keep telling myself again and again and again, I have to do this. I have to do this because for me there is no alternative. Right? For me there is no alternative. My goal only is to figure somewhere in the top 100. I mean, I should have that certainty. When I see that, you know, that PDF, that I should have that certainty that my name is there in that list. It's not like, you know, shivering before the result, or it's not like you open, you say my name is there, you tell your friend, check, my name is there. No, I want that kind of attitude. If I am sitting on that side, if somebody tells me what I am telling to you, I would do that. No matter, even if I suffering from fever, I will still write. Even if somebody is, you know, doubting me, I will still write. Even if I start writing very bad answers, I will still continue. I will know that, you know, I will start writing better answers later. So if somebody is not giving attention to me, those who needs, like the person who is speaking to you, I will go and chase him. Because I want to improve. I want to know what mistakes I am making, and I want to know, and I will chase that person because he has promised that, you know, if you follow this, the good things will happen. Even if I have to wait, I will wait. Even when I wait, I will not just wait and, you know, blame that I have to wait so much. But in that moment, I will write an essay. Like if I am sitting outside somebody's cabin waiting for their feedback, I will take pen and paper. I will go there, I will have a topic in my mind, I will write something, even let other people, you know, surrounding me, like let them make all kind of noises, complaints, everything. But even when I am in that kind of disturbance, I will do something productive. So this attitude where so next 1.5 years you want to get immersed in this journey, like when you eat, when you, you know, have dinner, when you have lunch, watch Rajya Sabha TV, right? I mean, you do this again and again, you won't go mad, don't worry, right? Some people do it, right? Better you also start doing it. I mean, like almost everybody wants to give full time for this preparation, right? You are not working, you are not committed to any other things. Right, and this is the most exciting part actually. I mean, you take pen, paper, start writing, start learning. I mean, the knowledge, the way it grows. You have to treat it with excitement rather than treating it as a burden. That is one mistake. Again, many people do it. When somebody tells them to write answers or complete certain thing, they actually treat it as a burden or a task to be completed. Let it be incomplete, it's okay. But next day when you wake up, try to do it again with excitement. Just changing the mindset, enjoying what you are doing, will sustain you for long. If you are not enjoying, if you are not liking what you are doing on day-to-day basis, like you won't sustain for long. For 1 month, 2 months, you will fall ill. Then again, you will change the track also. You will have to find a way to enjoy. You have to force yourself to like what you are doing. You might have changed optional, like it, love it, right? You will have to do answer writing. You will have to solve so many questions every day. Love doing everything. I mean, don't you think that is the beauty of this exam? You know, you are actually, some people think like, you know, I am wasting precious time of my life and all. So I see it other way. You are actually spending every day learning so many things again and again and again every day. And someday you have to just do the right thing when the actual exam comes, you know, sleeping properly day before the exam, and on the day of exam giving it just like any other exam, you know, having the right attitude. It is in that moment actually people fail. It's not during the preparation. Most people prepare to the level of getting 120 marks in prelims. They revise every question paper, they solve so many question papers, everything they do. But on that day, they commit new mistakes. The thing they were not doing here, the things they corrected, they undo everything in that moment of pressure. Right? So it happens in prelims, it happens in mains, it happens in interview also. And again, interview, people take it for granted. They actually don't give attention to interview preparation. In a way, this core batch actually helps you prepare better for interview also from day one. As I said, you will have to find newer version of yourself. The one who doesn't hesitate to talk to people. The one who comes out of, you know, their introvert shell. The one who learns to speak to the right people. And the one who sheds their ego, becomes humble, because you will have to get the feedback. So never act arrogant, right? You may be from, I don't know, whichever institution, whatever background, stay humble, stay, you know, rooted, grounded, and automatically you will see that, you know, everything starts favoring you, right? Do you have any doubts? No, we'll continue. Like till now, you have any doubts? You can ask if at all you have any doubts. Again, one more, that basic question. I know that today you'll get that motivation, tell yourself that I will write answers every day. Somewhere it breaks. I mean, how will you ensure that you will stay consistent every day? Can somebody give examples? Like if you have been consistent with something, maybe making notes from the Hindu, or if you may be writing answers regularly, how will you stay consistent?
We should ask ourselves like why we are here.
So you should keep asking like why you are here.
Yes.
Okay. Yes. Create incentive for? Acha, okay. So he's saying this, saying that 10 days if you consistently write answers, 11th day you can watch movie. Yeah, Sunday is anyway, you'll just have to write essay and watch movies. Right. But again, after writing essay, you should watch movie. Any other, maybe non-UPSC thing also, if you have been consistent, maybe hobbies. Somebody may be having the habit of reading, writing, painting. You may be doing it regularly. So why will you do it regularly? What it takes to do it regularly?
Interest.
How will you sustain that interest for long?
We should write our daily review what I have done.
Good. So you will write a daily review. Nice. Yes? Any other? That's a good suggestion actually. Keep a diary every day. At the end of the day, revise for 1 hour what you have done, review everything what you have done morning to night, and write it very briefly in your diary that, okay, these are my achievements today. I wrote these many answers, I have solved these many MCQs, I attended this test, out of 10 questions I attempted these many questions, I couldn't attend 2-3 questions because of maybe lack of knowledge or lack of time, lack of speed, something. So you have to do it. That's a good suggestion actually. Any other suggestion? Limitations to yourself in the sense? Achha. Yeah. I don't keep do's and don'ts list. Okay. Yeah, think about the competition. Exactly. That is very true actually. If you are relaxing today, maybe in the same class, those who are there, those who are preparing, you know, they'll be going ahead. They'll be moving ahead actually. Yes.
Older number 1126.
Achha. So write that 1126. It's a score in mains. The marks from optional essay and all GS papers, 1126. So 112 plus ensures you first rank. 1126 is the marks of first ranker this year, I think. 1122 was last year, 1121 was in 2016. So that 112 plus mains plus interview, actually it is not just mains, right? Maybe you can write that number every time you come to write the test. Again, giving these tests blindly will not help you. You will have to prepare. There is a fixed syllabus. When the orientation happens tomorrow, they will tell you what needs to be studied, how to prepare for every part of the syllabus. Follow that, prepare accordingly, and come to the exam with the sole aim of doing very well. Right? It is not like, you know, the attitude matters again. You should not come to the exam just because you have joined the program or you have to write the exam. When you start writing the exam, you will have to do your best, write the best possible answer in the beginning, and then slowly try to answer more number of questions. In the beginning itself, don't rush to complete entire paper, right? First focus on quality, try to again finding better version in the sense, earlier you might have faced problems of recollecting information. Here force yourself to collect more information, force yourself to do good analysis in the exam, in the answers, right? It should be betterment of your abilities. Every test is an opportunity, and slowly you will reach, like after say 1 or 2 months, like 2 months, you will reach a position where you will be in a position to write 20 questions in 1 hour. After two and a half months, you will certainly 100% reach that efficiency, right? Yeah, to coming back how to maintain consistency, there are ways. As she said, you know, you can maintain a diary, but I don't suggest this one. Doing things until you have to complete things, then only you will eat, sleep. It's okay. I mean, you have to, eating and sleeping never compromise. Health is more important than anything else in this world, right? If at all you have to prefer health or IAS, I'll tell health. You may be unhealthy and IAS, what will you do? Right? So health is number one. For health, good sleep, 3 times, having proper food is extremely important. Never compromise with that. But again, that doesn't mean discontinuing things. Like say till 1 o'clock you are doing something, so you can have lunch, then come back and continue that. What you are doing till 1 o'clock. Don't go back to sleep or something. So that discipline you should inculcate, you should maintain that. But to sustain consistency, again, if I were in your position, I will repeat that. I will treat the entire journey as the most enjoyable moment of my life. Instead of treating it as a burden, treating it as something to be completed, something to be achieved or something, I'll start treating this as, you know, it is going to help me. It is going to help me evolve as a better individual. It will make me a very learned person. And more than anything else, I will always remember the people, you know, who have done so much for me to be here, right? And the purpose, like, why am I doing it? I mean, the moment I feel like not doing it today, nahi, I will write only 2 answers today. Tomorrow I will compensate by writing 6 answers. It will never happen. I will slap on my face and I will tell that, no, write 2 more answers now, in this moment. Anything you postpone is gone. Right? That attitude is good. Like when you want to complete a book, sometimes complete it. If you have planned to complete in one, but again, be realistic. So Bipin Chandra, don't tell like I'll complete in one day. Right? Even if you want to complete, in the book won't allow you to complete, right? Some chapters and all. It's not like Alchemist where you read it in one day. Okay. So you have to be again realistic. Sometimes it's okay. Sometimes you will not be able to do things. Suddenly somebody comes and you will have to go out. Again, don't say no to people who, sometimes you have to attend functions, sometimes, but keep it to very limited days. Somebody suddenly comes from somewhere, you may have to go for lunch or dinner, shopping, right? But again, next day continue the cycle. What is expected of you on that day, you continue doing that. Maybe you can treat those episodes as a kind of break, right? Stress buster moments, rather than, you know, staying unrest, you know, you don't give attention to them also in that moment. Sometimes it happens, right? You are doing important tasks, suddenly somebody comes to you, your mind is all in that task. So they are talking to you, you are not listening to them, or not giving the attention. No, I mean, we have to learn to live in whatever moment we are living. If I am talking to you, if I am thinking about something else, so you won't listen to me, right? So any doubts? Yeah. So if you look at the timetable, I have an answer to that. Okay. So 3rd July is art and culture. Today is 28th. Yeah. And then 8th July you have test number 2 on art and culture. Like there is 5 days gap. Right. And then after that, in between essay and ethics comes. And then after the 12th July, again you have art and culture. So till 12th July, you have time only for art and culture, right? So why we are given like so much time, like nearly like 15 days only for art and culture is that whatever topics we have mentioned, you know, before every test, on that test you have to consolidate material, right? Like third, no, time is too late, like today and tomorrow you can try to do it. And how many days we have till 3rd July? Yeah, so it is sufficient actually. So maybe every day you can spend like, you know, 5-6 hours. The sources basically they will tell you. It will be either NCERT and selectively Nitin Singhani and NCERT Introduction to Art and Culture Class 11th Fine Arts book. Some parts from Tamil Nadu. 1 or 2 things from CCRT, right? So they will give actually the sources, exact sources. From that sources, if you are making it for the first time, notes, right? Very crisp one for, you know, like it should be one time effort. Like he said, like if you make that notes right now, next mains, till next mains, that is the only material. Something you write on, make something on Vijayanagara Empire from art you know, and architecture point of view. So that should stay with you till prelims and till mains. So that is why we are given so many days. You can divide, say, like 5 topics per day, something like that. So on 5 topics or 4 topics, spend like, you know, half an hour, 1 hour, make very short notes. Actually, tomorrow they will tell. The entire purpose of giving so much gap is the how it goes, you know, that I have studied the timetable. So we are completing GS1 first, then GS2 and GS3 as per the mains syllabus. By March, so everything will be over, GS1, 2, 3. In between, we have included ethics and essay. Ethics not in the end, because it's not good to study ethics just before prelims, like you cannot give time. That is why in between we have included, because it doesn't require that much of preparation compared to GS1, 2, 3. Alright, GS1, 2, 3, you need to spend more time because it helps both in prelims and mains. During that gap period, whatever subtopics we are given, on every topic you need to make small notes. Right. If you have already made notes, read, revise, and, you know, improvise them and come to the exam. If you haven't made notes, make notes that night, revise them, and before the exam, one day sit with all your notes, whatever you have made, memorize them. And while reading them, you know, keep thinking of the questions, the possible question that might come the next day, right? And you have to prepare in that manner. Every time you read something, think of a prelims question and think of a mains question on every topic. So when you make small notes, try to, you know, say it can be a possible prelims question. You note it down, and what possible mains question can come from that particular topic. And align this thing with, you know, current affairs. Like art and culture you are studying, it's fine. See the Hindu, if anything related to art and culture, anything from that, can you link it with the static? Even those topics also, you note them, right? Because in mains, if you have seen some anniversaries and all, from there only art and culture questions are coming. If something was in news, from there they take the int and frame a question in mains. So you have to combine both current affairs and the static part. So you will write secure, like for secure in the beginning 2 to 3 hours or 4 hours it might take, say 4 hours for optional, at least 4 to 5 hours for doing this core batch timetable. Never postpone doing it for the last day. The usual tendency will be, if July 3rd is the test, you will actually start seriously preparing only on July 1st or on July 2nd. Don't do that. Keep 4 to 5 hour slot only for core batch every day. Read the mentioned sources, make small notes, and again, once you make notes, it should be the end. Don't keep on making notes again and again. Right. So in this manner, again, the way you make notes and the way you prepare will be again thoroughly tested in the exam. And we have put a evaluation team of 10 members only for the core batch. So on time they will be evaluating, like, so 4 to 5 days maximum. So July 3rd test, the evaluated copies by, you know, 8th July you will get before next art and culture question. So that you will come to know, so what are your mistakes. So like that, so before every test, the previous test question, evaluated booklets will be made available. So any doubts? So in OGP 2019, if somebody is interested, again you need to again give the test. If you want to take part, we have like put fees at around 37,000 to 40,000. So as I told in the beginning, it's mainly for evaluation purpose. Right. So if interested, you can enroll. 2018, I don't think somebody is interested. So you pay whatever you think reasonable. So others, like it was 1.2, we have reduced it to 95. So whenever we talk about fees, you know, embarrassing actually. Wish we had means to do it entirely for free, you know. But the problem of doing anything for free of cost is that you people won't take it seriously. Never. You will do it for a few days, then stop doing it. I have this experience. Earlier when we were doing main test series for, you know, 15, so we were charging around 200-400 come and write. The first day you see, like, then even then 400-500 people. By midway 100-150, like 150. It's because you don't value it, right? And I tell you, so much effort is going to be behind this program from our side. It's not easy to, you know, prepare questions, prepare synopsis, evaluate. The evaluation is the main thing on a regular basis. And again, that will keep you, you know, consistent actually. Our sincere efforts from our side, regular evaluation, regular feedback will also help you stay consistent. If we start delaying giving you the papers, so that won't be happening yet. So I'll take care of that. We want maximum ranks, and I assure you, most of you will, you know, reach interview stage, majority of you, in this attempt. I'm not telling you everyone will get rank or majority of you will get rank, but I can assure you, if you take care of your optional and reach a stage where you can score 280 to 300, you will 100% reach interview. 100%. And again, there will be interview guidance. If you take it seriously, then I can tell you, you'll get a rank also. Immediately after means, we'll start interview guidance. So till interview, we intend to, you know, continue this batch. It's like one time investment for you. Any doubts? So, did I answer all of your doubts, sir? Yes.
I'm not very clear about how the feedback system
works. Okay. Yeah. First, you will write the test. After the test, there will be a discussion on the questions. Right. That is number one. Secondly, your copies will be evaluated by a team. And then when you get evaluated copies, you can come with your copy to me or to any faculty and say that this is how I got marks, right? So this is where I got less marks or more marks, how can I improve from there? That individual feedback we will give you. So I cannot come to your room, right? Like, where you stay?
No, I do understand.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah, you can come. You have to come, right? There is there any other mechanism? If it is not demand based, so it should be demand based, right? Is there any other mechanism? Like, I am open to suggestions. You can tell, like, or should we invite everyone with your answer copies and to the classroom? Again, that won't be possible. So it will be demand based in the sense you have to do it, as I told you, no? So when you want to improve, you come and show your copy and get the feedback.
So you can assure that you get your chance to
get the time? Yeah, 100%. Why? Because we are assigning mentors. For every 20 students, there will be a mentor. Like, what is possible to meet at least 2 times in a week. One mentor.
So is it that we need to meet the same mentor, or we can?
You can meet anyone, but better to meet one.
So would the same mentor evaluate our paper on the exams?
No. There is a separate team. You can meet evaluators also. The mentor is more about, you know, helping you with the content part.
So if same person evaluates our paper on the exams, so some X person evaluates my paper every exam, he will have very clear idea that how I'm going to do.
Yeah, that's what. So one person will be doing the evaluation. Any other doubts? That's a good question, but it is already mentioned in the program. We'll be doing it. For that, you may have to wait sometimes. Again, I told you, no? But just because you have to wait for 1 hour, half an hour, you shouldn't. So the intelligent thing to do is that bring something, read something when you are sitting. We have chambers for mentors. So outside that you can sit and, you know, or you listen to the feedback being given to others. You can productively use your time in n number of ways. What? Should we want ranks? We can do, that's not an issue. Yeah, all the evaluated copies we can just give ranks. If you want, we can give you, but it has both pros and cons. The topper wants. So my experience is that, you know, some people don't want to show their copies. Again, see, when you are in this process, it is not possible. Only after you become topper, we can show to next generation. No, even I actually encourage you to maintain your secrets. Truly, it's competition. Everyone sitting here is fighting for a rank. You may discuss among yourselves, you may everything, but maintain your own small secrets. It may be notes, the way you make. I mean, I'm honest with you. If you become too altruistic, no, it happens over the time. So you start helping others more than you start helping yourself. So don't do that, especially boys. Be intelligent. Right. Yeah, you can. So we will, once you know the admissions are final, by before July 3rd, so we will send you the list. Right, the list of mentors and for whom you are assigned. So you can regularly meet. We'll have an appointment system so that, you know, you will try to eliminate that waiting period. Any other doubts?
Can we show the answers of secure questions?
Yeah, that is what that mentoring is there, no? So you can, you will have to show. That is why we have reduced number. Fortunately, we are not going to have, I think, 200 numbers. We'll have somewhere 100 or less than 100. Anyway, it's very good actually. So you will get more time.
Are you available after this session if someone wants to speak
to you personally? Yes. So I usually run to that OGP. In that OGP I am available. Every day I am coming at around 10:30 and staying till 6:30. Sometimes except Saturday and Sunday. And sometimes when my nobody is there to look after my child, I will take a break. I have 1-year-old baby. He rarely, like, people will be there. Sometimes if somebody is engaged, then I will take care of him. Kind of excuse for me also. So, any other doubts? And most important message is stay happy. The core batch doesn't mean like putting the serious face and doing the things. You need to find reasons to stay happy even when things are not, you know, favoring you, and stay the course. But better to find your happiness by writing answers. And if you seek happiness outside this, again the priority usually shifts to that only. So within this you have to derive your happiness. Whenever you feel sad, you cry to Bipin Chandra, not on phone to someone else. Right. So when you are more very happy, excited that day, write more answers. Right. And after every test, you review your own performance. Right. It's not like we have the tendency, right? You write the answer, you close it, keep it and walk away. Right. So even when you are writing the exam, so last few minutes look at your answers, try to add value wherever it is possible, even you in that moment. So try to include more number of points. After going back home, review the question paper, you know, review the way you've written, check the sources, right? Like, were you able to reproduce most of the content? You check it from your notes. So notes compulsorily make. Earlier I was suggesting not to make notes. So for you, I am suggesting you have to compulsorily make. It helps. Again, better is write and make notes rather than that. What is that? Evernote is like the name as itself suggests. Evernote. You will never read it. It is like Evernote. Keep pasting here and there. Like you feel so happy. Systematically you are putting under each syllabus sets, segregating it. But you will never read it. Very few people read it. That is the experience, right? I mean, you might read it. It's not that I'm saying you will never read it. But it's different than compared to what you write and read. So, how many of you came from outside Karnataka here to attend this session? Very good. So, I will assure you, you will not feel what? You will not feel disappointed. The word cheated comes to my mind. So we are not going to cheat you or disappoint you, but for every aspirant I keep telling the intelligence lies within you to make maximum use of what is available to you. If you are not making use of the things available to you, you will end up complaining, right? So why people complain? Because they don't use the things. So they want things to come to them. Right. If you are not making use of it, you will always complain. Wherever you go, you keep complaining. Those who made use of all the tests and all, really they have done well in our previous programs. The same will happen here also. So wish you all the best. Right. Tomorrow there will be orientation in art and culture. So before this, again I am asking, if you have any doubts, please feel free to ask. Because, yes. Thank you very much. And I have to tell him, so he is Rajat sitting there. He was part of OGP 18. So I have never seen any guy who has been more consistent than him. People were doubting him. People were, you know, ridiculing him. I know that. Aray, ye toh prelims bhi nahi clear karega, mains bhi nahi karega. Intro mein toh he will score 120, 130, 140. So one of the former faculty actually told him outrightly he will not score more than 150 or 140. 140s. I mean, he was a teacher here. You know that. Who is that guy? So he told him outrightly that he will not score 140. So we took series of mocks and he was writing all the answers. He is missing rank by 3 or 8 marks.
5, 6.
Yeah, 5 marks actually. That was because he scored low marks in GS1. Nobody knows why. He was scoring 110 plus and all. There he scored 76 or 75? 73. GS1. Otherwise, he scored in essay, other GS papers, even interview 182. He went on to score 182 in interview. I'm sure he will score more than that in next attempt. Why he was able to do that? Other people were doubting him, but I was not doubting. I don't doubt anyone actually, those who keep coming consistently. I will always see scope for improvement. So I always see that you will actually become better as you keep working hard. So he scored 180 plus. It was shock to many people. So in interview, right? So his father keeps telling me, so his son scored better marks only because of me and all. I tell, it's not because of me, it is because of your efforts. If you don't have faith in someone, you will not put the efforts, right? Ultimately, it comes down to you. If you're not putting your efforts, if you keep doubting people, so you will not become better version of yourself. And always think on your own. Don't let your judgment be guided or modified or manipulated by others' opinions. If you want to find the truth, go and speak to the people, the person whom you want to be guided by, and you will know that, right? Okay, thank you very much. Wish you all the best.